It's Operation Wildfire Week here at Corvus Belli, and anyone could be a Shasvastii.
So check this out. Drop your comments using the hashtag Operation Wildfire on YouTube, Twitter, or Facebook for a chance to win exclusive limited miniatures like Aida Swanson, Submando Smuggler, and Victor Messer, Autonomous Agent of Chaos. Good luck, and keep connected.
Hello and welcome, this is Carlos Bostria, legendary brand ambassador. We are here in Corvus Belli Studios making videos for the Operation Wildfire Week. Behind the camera is Connie, legendary War Corps Admiral, and this video is all about designing O-12. So, in the following minutes we're going to go through all the concept designs for making the O-12 troops that goes inside the Operation Wildfire box and several further future boxes, and we will give you an introduction about the fluff and also the reasons and the path of thinking that took us from the whiteboard to the final concept designs. I think it's going to be pretty interesting because this is a new faction for Infinity. This is the greatest thing ever happening in 2018, doesn't matter where are you looking at, okay? Look at me, sir. NA2, Toha, Aleph, Nomads, Combined Army, Hakislam, Ariadna, Eugene, Pano, no O-12 here. Why? Because this is totally new. It's not even in my shirt, okay? Now we have to make a new shirt with O-12 over here, okay? So, let's take a look at the concept designs. Shall we begin? Here we go. Okay, let's begin with the Delta unit, okay? Deltas, okay, like the Delta Force. So we're playing homage to the brave men of the Delta Force here with making the O-12 paratroopers the Delta units, okay? These guys are totally looking for the next adrenaline boost, and they jump into action and they love to be in the middle of the battle. Let's take a look at all the elements that we have included here in this dossier. The first thing you will notice is that you can see a lot of weaponry that seems like Aleph weaponry. In fact, yes, it is. It's Aleph weaponry, but it's not that exactly, okay? Aleph uses the weapons that O-12 allows them to use, okay? O-12 is above Aleph, okay? The way of releasing Aleph and O-12 separately, because despite of that they are very well integrated, is because we always wanted Aleph to have more entity, okay? Because it has a more decisive role in the whole plot and a storyline of Infinity. So Aleph is separately. But fluff-wise, O-12 has the Bureau Toth that is constantly supervising Aleph and hunting renegade AIs. It's all about AI, okay? Controlling all the AIs, the artificial intelligences. So the Bureau Toth is totally for supervising Aleph. Whenever Aleph, the SSS, intervenes in a battle, is under supervision of O-12. O-12 decides if they can act, okay, and to be deployed. Whenever you see O-12 units collaborating with Dakini Tagbots or Deva functionaries, Aleph troopers with them, is because O-12 has asked for reinforcements or has decided to follow a path, a hint that Aleph SSS has found. So, apart from that, you will find plenty of collaboration with Aleph and O-12. They go together. And they are both factions that have a restrictive jurisdictional zone, okay? They need permission. Aleph needs permission from O-12, and O-12 needs permission from other factions to intervene, or at some point, actively deciding to get into the middle of the stuff, really. So, they are not planetary armies or big faction armies covering their ground. They are a faction that decides to jump in the spot because they decide it's necessary to do it, okay? So you have some hints of the fluff, very interesting there. So yeah, O-12 miniatures will have Aleph weapons, okay? But it's not that simple. Okay, so we have here how Roberto Zoreda, the designer of this troop, has used many different shapes, okay, to create the O-12 jump pack, okay? And you can see there many different packs that are attached to the body and many different layers of design that have finally composed the Delta unit. See how this translates into 3D. We have a very faithful translation here. We can see all the elements that have become volumetric now, and we can see that the Delta unit is like a hacker option for the paratrooper, okay, with that extended arm. very good translation from the 2D design into 3D, which is the most interesting thing of this video, in my opinion. Shall we continue? Let's go. Kappa unit, and we have here two versions, male and female. This is the starting point for every faction, the line infantry, okay, the basic troop, okay, the fusilier, okay, in a certain way. Many decisions regarding the whole faction were made from this starting point. You can see that there's a subtle difference. We allow here Roberto Zoreda, who is the author of these designs, to implement some shadow, okay, some shadows to the design, in order to see how the shade of blue that we're using here will look in the final miniature, because the shade of blue of this particular design has been a nightmare since the beginning, okay? Because every army that gets painted in blue will look like Pano, really. So we have to really be careful with the shade of blue and the combination with the golden, okay? Because the fluff stays since the beginning, since 2005, that O-12 troops will go in navy blue and golden, okay? So trying to find the proper color for the artwork, for the miniatures, for the designs, was like, hey, more blue, less blue, darker, more light. So there was a lot of decisions regarding color over there. So Kappa units are the most basic line infantry of O-12, okay? Backbone of this army as usual, and we have here the translation into 3D with two female troops, okay, and one male troop. It's always very important for me to include in the battle packs miniatures that are holding the rifle straight and aiming and shooting forward, because those miniatures are also very useful to explain rules with them, okay? Because the basic 101 Infinity tutorial is always the basic troop aiming to the front, and you will explain all the roles, make graphics with them for making the rules, very important. Gangbusters, crime operative unit, okay? This unit has a different fluff regarding the rest of the O-12 unit. As you can see, the design has a lot of charisma, a lot of personality there, a guy with tattoos looking like a... And this guy has been a criminal, has a criminal past, has been infiltrated in the criminal underground, because this unit are usually like infiltrated cover-up agents, okay, looking for plots, conspiracy, criminals, or trying to solve issues in the human sphere, okay? So that was, this guy has so much charisma. This design, unlike the others, has been made by Carlos Torres, the art director of Gobus Belli, and you can see that he likes always to make the badass guy, okay, because this guy is the badass. So let's take the miniatures, let's take a look. Crouching pose with the boarding shotgun, okay, and you can see that the guy is really made for business. Look at how the 3D translates all the 2D shapes into a really tough guy holding the weapon, okay? Epsilon unit, okay, the elite sniper for O-12 in this box, and the Epsilon units are usually elite high rank officers, okay, not only trained for combat and being super elite snipers, also they have a lot of diplomacy and negotiating skills, and they are sometimes, when they are not in combat, they have to deal with politics and really complicated relations of interest, and they have to be in the middle of that, okay. You will read in the fluff how good they feel when they are called for action and using their weapons instead of having to deal with politics. So, the pose, the final miniature of this design made by Roberto Zoreda, the final translation into 3D, you can see there how well adjusted it has been, okay? Take a look at those pouches, those pockets on the chest that are not so prominent in the miniature finally, and that standing pose is lovely miniature to paint, in my opinion. You will like to build a sniper tower just to do your own terrain piece, just to put this guy on the top, in my opinion. Really cool pose. Okay, moving on. Gamma unit. This was the most complicated design to pull off, okay, because it's a Silhouette 5 heavy infantry unit. Usually this carries a lot of weight, a lot of shapes, and you have here a guy who is holding a weapon in the concept design, not usual, this kind of stuff in Infinity concept designs. This design has also been made by Roberto Zoreda. And we have the version here in the final box with the feuerwerk in his hands, okay? Demolishing guy with lot of power in the legs, lot of weight. It's difficult sometimes to articulate this kind of legs because the real foot of the soldier is not on the ground, is in the upper surface that you can see there. And we can see also a very volumetric backpack, okay? The silhouette fire, the big miniature, okay? Very important for group shots, always, this guy. Hippolyta, Amazon officer dossier, okay? We have here the Aleph/O-12 character/Aristeia fighter/pre-order miniature, all kinds of awesome are happening. You can see a lot of Greek themes over there. You can see lots of common design elements that put her closer to the Myrmidons from Aleph than any other O-12 unit. And we allow ourselves to put a cape over there. This design has been made by Carlos Torres. And he went all kinds of crazy with the posing. Look at that dynamic jump posing, okay? Perfect for getting into close combat in Infinity or getting into Aristeia also, because you can also use this metal miniature in Aristeia. So welcome to the Hexadom, okay? Moving on, we have a few more designs, because for Gen Con we have an advanced pack, okay? These miniatures will be released in blister later in the year, but it's part of the super bundle that we're making for Gen Con, and I can totally recommend it to you, because you will hear about Team Sirius, okay, all year and next year, because everybody will play with this, okay? Is a female unit synchronized with a mecha drone thing, okay? Very strange and very new to Infinity. We have here a female rank officer, okay, with a long coat and shiny parts on them, okay? And the guy who totally steals the spotlight is the remote drone feline creature that goes next to her. These creatures go synchronized with the Team Sirius officer, and these are here to bring something unique to the table, really. Okay, I haven't seen anything like this in Infinity. The closest thing will be the creature that goes with Andromeda, really. But this is different, and I like very much the execution. Look at how the 2D design translates perfectly into 3D here. Okay, great work there by the sculptor, really. Thank you so much for your attention. Drop your comments below using the hashtag Operation Wildfire, okay, to have a chance to win some Infinity goodies. I'm sure that you will like it. Okay, I hope this video has been enjoyable for you, with certain bits of love and certain bits of the decisions for making the designs. We will have more videos during this week. I hope you like it and all. Thank you so much. Comment on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, everything. Thank you so much. Bye.